All right, Governor Hogan unveiled his plan on Friday, three phases to reopen Maryland, and it would really start 14 days after the numbers were going down, and maybe we're in that phase right now, so it's possible early May. It could happen. That's the earliest, more likely mid-May or late May. But three phases. First phase, lift the stay-at-home orders, reopen some businesses. You could golf. You could do fishing, boating, some outdoor stuff. Second phase is really the big one, where you would open more public activities, larger gatherings, and restaurants would be able to open as well, religious gatherings, and even some daycare centers as well. Michael Greenberger joins us now. Director of the University of Maryland Center for Health and Homeland Security and a constitutional lawyer. Always good to have you on. I appreciate you coming on the show. What do you think about the plan here in our state?
Well, I think it's a very good plan. I think it's well thought through. And the most important part of the plan is that it's based on science. It's based on public health factors. There's no arbitrary decision that things will open up, which you're finding some governors doing. Primary example is Georgia, where tattoo parlors and other services where people are in close contact with each other are opening up. The important thing about the plan is the fact that the cases of infection and deaths have to be on an onward trend for 2 weeks. And that is the model I think that most public health experts are adopting, and I think it's very safe and prudent and reflects the high level of scientific and medical advice the governor is getting.
I'm interested to get your take on this. As someone, you know, studies homeland security issues, do you worry that the longer this goes on, especially the more people lose their jobs, the weather gets nicer, people are cooped up inside, that people just say, frankly, screw this. I'm going out. I can't deal with this anymore. And what that might do when it comes to public health and as well as security issues.
I think everybody would be worried about that. And in fact, a lot of what we're seeing, and again, I point to Georgia, which is sort of the prime example where things are opening up on an arbitrary basis without any scientific underpinning. I think what people have found to be quite amazing is that you're quite right. The tension between taking care of your health and taking care of your income or your well-being is at a very high level, but that people are basically, I think, quite worried about being infected, quite worried about what the result is, and by and large, people have been at the forefront of really wanting to follow the best scientific advice. So what you say is worrisome,
Yeah. But
I think what the governor has done is put us on a path where sometime in May these things will open and we'll be back doing the kinds of things we want and need to do, but doing it on a safe basis.
Yeah, we're talking with Michael Greenberger, director of the University of Maryland Center for Health and Homeland Security. He's also a constitutional lawyer. Look, this is happening across the globe as well, but, you know, people want to know what's going to happen in their own backyard. When you look at things, and I mean, I know you're not making these decisions, but when you look at, you know, what could happen in the summertime, you're like, can you open beaches up? I mean, is that too much? I mean, can you allow people to go to Deep Creek Lake, the normal things that we do in the summertime, or is that going to look completely different? I mean, we didn't really get a detailed answer from Governor Hogan on that, but what do you think it may look like in the summertime around here?
I think it's a very close proposition as to whether we can go back to business as usual. I think the plan that's been outlined by the governor will always have attached to it the requirement of social distancing. So I think the most important thing is getting people to a position where they get back to work, where they can maintain their income or restore their income. That will probably have to be done with social distancing attached to it. For example, restaurants are not going to be run the way they've usually been run. That being said, I think we just have to wait and see where we are as we get to, say, Memorial Day or a day where we traditionally open things up. But I wouldn't be surprised at all if we're going to have to wait to have our beaches opened as we usually have them opened. If they are open, there'll probably be orders of not gathering in crowds, et cetera.
Yeah, and social distancing at the beaches as well. So on the constitutionality of this, we know the governors obviously have a tremendous amount of power here. Do they control all the decisions, or do mayors have their individual powers as well? I mean, who ultimately has the trump card here?
Well, under the statute, Maryland state statute or statutes that the governor is operating under, it's his call. He has the primary authority. But we have people on my staff who are working throughout the states with, for example, county public health agencies. There's a lot of coordination. And I would say also take Montgomery, Prince George's, City of Baltimore, Howard County. There are decisions being made there. Again, based on science, a lot of hard work being done. It's all being coordinated with the state. So we've got a lot of good thinking. And by the way, more than good thinking, we have people working 12-hour shifts in various health facilities. They have problems with their children, making sure their children are cared for. There are a lot of sacrifices being made. But I think we're fortunate in the state of Maryland to have the best thinking being applied to this. It will be slower than we want, but I think we're going to come out of this in a safe and effective way, and probably sooner than we would think as we sit here today.
Well, I like the sound of that. Thank you, Mike. Always good to have your thoughts and your expertise on the show. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Michael Greenberger, director of the University of Maryland Center for Health and Homeland Security, and a constitutional lawyer.